What is the unique value of a business? It's something that makes the business stand out from every other business. Think of In-N-Out, Oracle, Red Bull, Yeti. These are all great businesses that operate in what's called a blue ocean. If you're interested in learning more, please continue listening. Welcome to the Red to Black podcast hosted by Warner and Mario, two Marine officers and businessmen. In this series, Bootcamp, we go over the basic foundational building blocks of business to make you a better businessman or woman. I'm going to read a quick little segment from Oracle's annual report, which describes why they are one of the top database SaaS companies in the world. Providing choice and flexibility to Oracle customers as to when and how they develop Oracle applications and infrastructure technologies is an important element of our corporate strategy. We believe that offering customers broad, comprehensive, flexible, and interoperable deployment models for Oracle applications and infrastructure technologies is important to our growth strategy and better addresses customer needs relative to our competitors, many of whom provide fewer offerings, more restrictive deployment models, less flexibility for customers' transitions to cloud-based IT environments. Mario, what are your thoughts? That's a mouthful, but it's the core of what they do.
All right, for my nephews who are still awake, basically unique value proposition of a business is offering the highest quality product or service in the market space. Always go, if you're going to start a business or you're going to invest in business, always go with the business that's providing the marketplace with the highest quality product or service. That's what Oracle is executing. They're giving their customers the best, most reliable, fastest, most flexible. They're offering the best service in the marketplace to their customer. And that is a value proposition. That's a unique value proposition that business is providing. And they have a wonderful brand. Those red Oracle letters are extremely powerful. And that's a great business. Most companies are competing on price. They're trying to attract customers by going down, down, and down, and down. And that's a race to the bottom. An airline company is selling seats based on price. They're buying a brand, a Boeing or a Bombardier or an Airbus, and they're selling a commodity, an airline seat. That's a horrible business to be in. Oracle is providing the highest quality service and products, servers to their customers. And they're doing it at a phenomenal, phenomenal value proposition where you have reliability, redundancy, flexibility. It's a wonderful business and it has a wonderful brand. Those are my thoughts, Warner.
Yeah. So let's look at great points, Mario, to build on what you're saying. Let's look at those two different companies and why they have different value points and why one's operating on price and one's operating on brand and raising its prices every year. So the airline industry, right? You talked about if you go on any airline, whether it's United, Delta, they have the same amount of seats, they have the same aircraft, they have the same pricing. It's like the same exact experience. Now, there are certain airlines like Etihad. I don't know if I said that right.
Etihad.
UAE, I mean, you know, because you've been over there, you've probably flown them. A lot of these Middle Eastern airlines, they know how to create like a high, but they're still, like we talked about, the physical form.
They're subsidized by the oil states that they own. They're owned and operated and subsidized. Yeah. So you want the best experience in the world of flying. Go to Saudi Arabia, United Arab Emirates, Qatar, Bahrain, Oman. Their airlines are unbelievable, unbelievably quality. The people running those airlines, unbelievable service. And at a reasonable price. I mean, it's the same as Delta. If you want to fly to UAE, you can fly Etihad or you can fly Delta or United. The difference is they're getting free fuel. They're getting subsidized by those. They're not actually paying the fuel bill. They're paying this fraction fuel bill because the states that own those airlines float on oil. So
here's an interesting side point to what Mario was saying and what I was kind of pointing at, which is the form of a business. Now, I just wrote an article on this describing the form of Oracle and how it just like exceeds an oil business. You can only do so much with the form of a business to create more efficiencies in your cash flow or more profit. And what Mario just described is a perfect example. You have the airline industry, which competes on like seats, pricing, but that one airline, which I cannot say the name, is Etihad. Yeah. is And for Arabic speakers, I apologize. That airline is doing the best that it can do with subsidies in a low margin business. So it's offering just a little bit more, like the value points, which differentiate it, are it's offering more comfort, better food, great customer service. That's why it's a unique value for a certain set of wealthy customers. Most airlines are offering the same thing for a wide range of customers. That's the value points, seats, price, boom. It's just simple, commodity value points. They trade on commodity exchange. Now you go to Oracle. Mario kept, I talked about it in the article or in the 10K, which I read, and Mario reiterated it, is flexibility, durability or reliability, right? Speed at which it runs up the operational environment for any business. These three value factors, customer service, those four value factors hit a certain market, corporate, government, educational, a business or institution. It hits those four value points really, really sync up with what those companies are into. And it creates this loyalty and this trust. That's the unique value. You have certain value points that sync up with the values that a customer base is looking for. And when they marry up and there's a symbiotic sort of relationship, synchronicity, it creates this loyalty and this trust. And that creates a brand. That's a unique value. If you want a really great book on it, the Blue Ocean Strategy really describes the difference between a Red Ocean Airlines and a Blue Ocean Oracle. It really breaks down unique value. And this is essential for investors because once you've picked like a 20 or 30% operating margin business, you want to know that business is going to be around for a while. How do you know it's going to be around for a while? They've built a phenomenal brand. Like Red Bull, oh my God, it'd be so hard to take that business out. People just wake up and just go, I got to have my Red Bull. Like Jamie O'Brien, the pro surfer, like the pro skier, the pro mountain biker. There's not only got a great taste to it, but it's also got a great association with these pro athletes. Just phenomenal brand. Any other thoughts, Mario?
Yeah, just a couple more, Warner. Oracle, I've been using Oracle logistics software for 17 years. It just works. The Marine Corps could afford to go anywhere. The Marine Corps is a big enough organization with enough money. We could go to any software company and get a logistics software platform. We keep going back every year to Oracle or whatever our contract is. We keep going back to Oracle because it just works. It provides the speed. It provides uptime. It provides security. It just plain works well. I'd go like this. If Hawaiian Airlines and Alaska Airlines are still around 100 years from now, it's because the state of Hawaii or the state of Alaska has subsidized those airlines. I have a great confidence that Oracle will be around 100 years from now and Red Bull will be around for 100 years from now because the value they provide their customers, it's a unique value proposition. It's not a commodity business. It's a branded, wonderful, the highest quality product that they can provide their customers. So they have a real good chance. Red Bull and Oracle have a real good chance of being around 100 years from now. Hawaiian Airlines and Alaska Airlines, they'll be lucky if they're around 100 years from now, and they'll only survive if they're subsidized by the states.
And here's what's interesting. If you're investing in a business or thinking about building a business, we've talked about this before. What most people don't think about when building a business is that profit margin or the business model. Why is that important? Well, for what Mar and I have seen, the higher margin businesses usually have better quality brands. It's really hard to brand a commodity business because you're dealing with something. You're like, oh, that gas station. I mean, it's no different than that gas station. How are you like, I mean, okay, if you're F1, Formula One, you got like a really good quality gas, I get it, but that's unique. But for most people, you're like, dude, that gas is the same as that gas. That you're setting in front of yourself a really, really tough challenge of running like an oil business. This is not to say that the gas station business is a low margin business because it's not. We're talking about the oil business, like branding Shell or branding. They've tried it. You brand Shell and the prices are through the roof. I'm like, I can't pay that much for that gas or Chevron. Those Chevron Shell, those prices are like up here. And you've seen they're trying to do this branding play. But I've looked at the 10K of Shell and Chevron and it's still like 5%, 10% operating margin business. You look at Oracle, Microsoft, 40% operating margin business. So guys, if you're going to look at building a business, look at building a highly profitable business, and it'll be much easier for you to brand that business. And you guys for listening, subscribe, like, comment. And as always, We look forward to connecting with you in the future.